Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Dual Research Service. Today we are covering question number 213 of top 300 MCQ of Indian Evidence Act. If you are not watching the previous videos, so I will provide these link of these videos in comment box. Now starting here, question number 271. The rigor of conclusive presumption of a legitimacy under section 112 of evidence of Indian Evidence Act can only be rebutted by the DNA testing of paternity, non-access of parties, the fact that wife was observing the menstrual period, the fact that the wife has undergone the tubectomy recently. So in this question, answer is here, the non-access of parties. Question number 272. In which of the following case, the Supreme Court of India said that it is not absolute rule of law that dying declaration must be corroborated by other evidence before it can be acted upon. Sarat Birdichandra Sarda versus State of Maharashtra, Pakla Narayan Swami versus Emperor, Kausal Rao versus State of Bombay, Harjeet Kaur versus State of Punjab. In this question, answer is here, Kausal Rao versus State of Bombay. In this question, the Supreme Court said that there is not an absolute rule of law. The dying declaration must be corroborated by other evidence before it can be acted upon. Question number 273. According to Indian Evidence Act, a fact is said to be not proved when the court believes that the fact does not exist. The court considers it is not existence probable. The fact is neither proved nor disproved. The court considers its existence doubtful, beyond a reasonable doubt. So in this question, answer is here, option C. The fact is neither proved nor disproved. So not proved means the fact is neither proved nor disproved. Question number 274. Indian Evidence Act deals with relevancy of evidence, reliability of evidence, admissibility of evidence. Select the correct answer using the code given below. Option A and B, option B, A, option 1 and 3, sorry here, option 1 and 2 only, option 1 and 3 only, only 3 and 1, 2, 3. So in this question, the Indian Evidence Act deal with the relevancy of evidence, not reliability, and admissibility of evidence. So option, these two are correct. So answer is here, option B. Question number 275. The cross-examination of one's own witness is permissible only after obtaining the permission of court, not permissible with the consent of opposite party. So here answer is option B, permissible only after obtaining the permission of court. Question number 276. Indian Evidence Act declared that anything said, done or written by any one of the conspire is relevant to prove a conspiracy if it was in pursuance of their common intention, reference to their common intention, prosecution of their common intention, redeeming their common intention. So in this question, answer is here, reference to their common intention. Question number 277. According to Indian Evidence Act, the burden of proof is a suit or proceeding lie on the person. A, who is instituted a suit or proceeding, against whom the suit or proceeding is instituted, who would fail if no evidence at all were given on their either side, and whom the court may call upon. So it always on a who instituted a suit or proceeding. Option A is correct here. The oral account of content of fraudulent document by a person who has seen it is the testimonial evidence, primary evidence, circumstantial evidence, none of the above. So here answer is none of the above. The oral account of content of document by the person who has seen testimonial evidence, no, primary evidence, circumstantial evidence, none of them. Question number 279. The question in cross examination, the must be confined to the fact satisfied by the witness on his examination in chief, need not to be confined to the fact testified by the witness on his, can be asked to test the patience and the withstanding capacity of witness both B and C. So here answer is option B is correct here. Need not be confined to the fact testified by the witness on the his examination in chief. There are three type of examination I already expressed here. Examination in chief, cross and re-examination. Question number 80. A wishes to prove a dying declaration by B. The burden of proof that B is died is on the state, the family member of B, the legal heir of B, and option D is A. So it is on A, because A is wishing to prove the dying declaration by B. So now the burden of proof is on A. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and please click on bell icon for further videos. Thank you.